Today I'll be showing you how to make this really cool purple, or whatever color you want to do, guitar pick. And today I'll be using this lime green color. You do not need this many bands. I just grabbed a handful, but I think you use around 28, maybe 30 bands. So just, I don't count my bands, I just grab it. I overestimate and got a handful. And so I'll be showing you how to make this, and what you'll need is a loom of any kind, and it needs to be doing its stagger. It needs to be in the stagger configuration with the arrow pointing down. Okay, and then you'll need a hook, a crochet hook, or a hook that came into your loom. Okay, so let's get started. I'm going to turn on my music. There we go. So we're going to use two bands through it all unless I tell you otherwise. So if you're not sure, just remember two bands. Two bands. Go out. Two bands. Go out. So it should look something like that now. Bands. Two bands. Now we're going to do that again. We're going to take two bands like this. Now we're going to take two bands and we're going to go out like that. So it should look like this. Now I'll take two bands and we're going to go from this peg all the way to this one. Ooh, I like this song. So it should stretch like this. There's just that gap between there. And I'm kind of basing it off a snow cone, the bottom of the snow cone charm, but I'm doing my own kind of things. But, so it's my own charm. There's no other charms like this on YouTube. In fact, I think it's the only, guitar pick charm. It's not a full guitar, it's just a guitar pick. You want to see it again. See, that we're making the point in the shape right now. We have not hooked it, but doing the hooking process yet. Okay, now take your hook. Take a single band, kind of stretch it out first, and wrap it around like that. So you should see two loops. And make a triangle. So you should see that kind of triangle form on your loom. So you took a double band. Oops, I messed up. Single band, sorry, I messed up right there. Double it. There we go. So, you should see something like that. So I'm gonna get up and close my door. Okay, anyway, so you should see that triangle form. Take another single band, stretch it out. Don't break your band, so don't stretch it that much. Just stretch it where it's kind of, you know, oops. I slingshotted my band somewhere. Okay, sorry. So you're gonna slingshot your band where it's kind of roomy. Don't break it while you're doing it. Don't do it super hard. Okay, now you're gonna go around three times. So you should see three loops. We're going to do the triangle again. And If you have lower quality bands and they won't go around two times, you can do two times. You just won't get that really super triangular form at the bottom, that super point that makes this charm unique. Oops, I lost the band. Do that again. You just won't get that point. It's tight. It won't look as good. See, not using very good bands. They might not go around three times. So I only doubled that band because it lost its third knot. Huh. It's not going around three times. Let's try this again. Stretch. Sorry about that noise. That was just my elbow hitting my remote. I hit something. They won't go around. There! Aw, it broke. Seriously. Let's try this again with a different band. I'll eventually get this, so if I'm going really slow, just fast forward in the video. It broke again. I'm going to get a different band to do this. I think I got a stronger band. It's just a little bit of a darker color. I would not recommend doing another color, but I'm going to do this because this one band's kind of stronger, I think. I hope so. If this doesn't do it, then I guess I'll just have to do it twice. I'm really hoping it works. And there we go. See, I was just using I was using really tight bands, the Rainbow Loom brand. I don't know why they weren't stretching. So anyway, you should see those two triangles. Again, I would not recommend using a different color or a different shade. It just wouldn't look as good. But I could not get mine to go around three times and then do that. So you should see exactly. Okay, just making sure it went around three times. So now you'll take your hook and wrap it around four times. We're going to make a cat band right now. Okay, so once you have that four times, you should see four loops. But you'll take it and put it on there. There we go. So now we'll start a hooking process. So we're going to turn our loom around like this. Or you can keep it like this. I'm going to keep it like this so you guys can see better. I'm going to move my bands out of the way as we're done with rubber bands now. Okay, so we're going to reach under the cat band and grab the top two bands and bring it to the original peg that it was on. So you should see that really stretched teardrop. I'm going to push my bands down. Okay, so reach under, grab the next top two, and bring it to there. Oops, I got three bands. Put that back. There we go, I got them, I think. There we go, okay. I grabbed the other bands too. Okay, so now reach under your cat band, grab those two, and pull it to the peg in front. It might be kind of tricky getting around. Oh, I see what I did. I grabbed one of my wrong bands. Put that back. Sorry, I messed up. Let's get it back how it was. So I guess we have those two bands to put them to the top like that. Oh, I only grabbed one band. No, I grabbed them all. Okay. That looks good. Okay. So, now grab next two, pull them to the top. Now we're just doing the normal hooking process till the end. So if you're a speedy loomer, which I am not a speed loomer, then you can go ahead and make it. Ooh, it's hard to go under that really tight band. There we go, finally. So grab the next two, pull them to the top, and you should see that teardrop forming. So if you don't see that teardrop, kind of pull on it, but don't pull on it hard enough or it will break. Again, grab next two, pull them to the top. There we go. Now you kind of see the teardrop forming. Now grab two, pull them to the top, go under, grab them. Go under. And if you have any suggestions of what you think I should make, right now I'm working on a monkey face. But anyway, just leave comments on anything that you want me to make. Because right now I've only made two charms. I've made the guitar pick, and I've made a, what did I make? I'm trying to remember what I'd made. Oh, I made a, what's the name? I can't remember whatever I made myself. I'm still thinking though. I'll tell you once I remember. I currently don't remember. Okay, so once you've done that full hooking process, it's going to get a little bit tricky. So you should see those two sets right there. Now you're going to grab those, the bottom part, and pull it onto the top. So now we're creating a slip knot. Now grab those two bands and kind of tug. Don't be too rough though, or you'll break it. Break the bands. So that's why I did double bands, just so if a band breaks, then you'll still have a backup band. Okay, so now we're ready to take it off the loom. Looks like I forgot to hook one of the bands because it's loose. But that's okay. No big deal if you forgot to hook one. Just make sure you at least hooked one of them. Because I just forgot to hook one out of two. So I just had to cut that band off. The one that I forgot to hook. That's part of the reason I use double bands. Because it... For one of the... Oops. My moped tried to pop out on me. Okay, so there you have it. Your guitar pick. So now I'm going to show you how to hide this band. But first, I'm going to cut this extra band that I laid out. Grab my scissors. And if you hooked yours right, I didn't hook mine right. That's why I did that. But you do not need to cut anything. I just had to cut that because I forgot to hook it. But anyway. So there's your guitar pick. Hope you liked it. If you want to leave this extra bands, then you can go ahead and end your video. But I'm going to show those who want to hide it. So it looks like this. I'm going to hide it now. Okay, so you're going to reach under any random close bands, and you're going to grab your two holding bands. You're going to pull those random bands over that, and then pull your holding bands like that. So now they're just kind of hidden in there. Just kind of pull them, make sure they stay there. Okay, so there you have it, your own little guitar charm. Hope you enjoyed it. This one's a little bit smaller than this one, but anyway, really hope you liked my video. Please like, subscribe, comment, leave anything that you want me to make next. And just give me advice if I didn't do my video very well and you couldn't see. Thanks for watching.